Twitter or something. I don't even remember how we met. But somehow on social media we met. And he is a real estate guy. He runs a blog website. And so he jumped in to start blogging around real estate, learning about that. And he really is a great example of learning by doing, extremely knowledgeable, and everything he's going to talk to you about, everything he ever would talk to you about, he knows because he's done it, has experienced it firsthand. And it's just, I mean, it's just a sponge for learning new stuff and understanding it. So from a technical standpoint, knows a ton of stuff. Especially about, really knowledgeable on stuff that I don't pay much attention to, SEO. He's come and talked to classes, previous classes about SEO, but since we really don't talk about that, it wasn't something they clued into. And what he's going to talk about tonight is not something that we're going to talk about, but it's just so contemporary. I mean, it is so germane to marketing, which is the bigger picture of what we're doing. We were branding, but that's marketing. So he's going to talk about QR codes, which I don't get. So I'm looking forward to this as well. What a QR code is, how you use it, why you use it, things of that nature. So, you ready?
Yeah.
Here's a, I got a bottle of water for you. Too.
Cool.
And, you need a...
I just need to leave here.
That's the other three.
There's my water slide here, too. There's not a ton of slides, so I mean, it's not a deal.
I know it didn't work for me.
It's fine. It's the only deal.
The laser works, but this didn't work. There it is. Just slow. This computer's slow. So it just hit. That's all. Yeah. And this is this is your water. If you want.
Okay.
So you're recording. I won't record that.
Oh, no, go ahead, especially if you got good sound, or sound lame, or my really good camera gave up on me.
He's closer than I am, so.
Okay, well, he introduced me somewhat. My name is Ron Bell, realtor for 20 years, accidental social media consultant. Kind of how I got to be where I am right now with both social media and QR codes is I kind of had to go to a buyer's model, and of course the buyers on the internet, that's how I learned that stuff. So we're going to mostly talk about QR codes and how and why did I start getting into QR codes. I used to live in France, Chamonix, France. I don't know how many skiers and climbers are here. So all through Europe and Japan, Great Britain, are QR codes. And I'll show you some in a bit. They're just simply, you've probably seen them. They're just square devices. And I was going to put a big one up there, but it's just, I didn't want to blow it up. One thing about QR codes, they get a little tricky when you try to make images of them and blow them up, especially on the PowerPoint, so I didn't have time to mess around with them. You've probably seen them. I got some do's and don'ts in a file with me as well. They started getting popular here in the United States about the last, I'd say, 8 to 14 months, depending on kind of smartphone device you have, especially once, of course, the iPhone enabled you to take pictures. So it's mostly the Droids and the iPhone, which work wonderful with QR codes. It'll actually work with a lot of cell phones, too. So it just depends on what you're using. It connects mobile to traditional media is a really good way to describe it. I use them mostly in real estate. They're wonderful in real estate. You have sign writers. We put them on our flyers, brochures, things like that. So real estate, what about real estate and internet marketing in general? Because we're very early adapters, because we're photo-rich, we're video-rich, and we want to get our name out there. So I jumped on the QR code bandwagon before you could even download these things. It was just kind of more of a fun thing for me, and it's kind of, it just kind of surprised people and bewildered them a little bit. Now, everybody's got them, and there's a right way and a wrong way. So what we're going to learn tonight is we're going to kind of touch on the who, what, where, how, and why. And a lot of, so what, who cares? Is this stuff going to work for you? There's a lot of just abuse, frankly. I'm a little bit of a curmudgeon, by the way, with QR codes, because I see so much people using them wrong. Kind of like with social media. We see it every day. It's like, oh my God, are you doing that? Are you kidding me? because we somewhat know the right way, and when we see the wrong way, it really glares at us. And any people in this class, we're going to know the wrong way and the right way of social media, hopefully QR codes by the end of this presentation. So we'll get into some questions later, and I will give it for you later too. I'm sure we'll surprise. The name QR stands for, well, I call it quite redundant because we're seeing them quite a bit. They're called quick response, and I call them quite redundant because we're starting to see them everywhere, and they start to be redundant, and people don't quite understand in the United States. In the United States, you kind of got to give you a little bit of instruction with them right now. They're basically a mobile phone readable barcode. It's as simple as that. A lot of times, in the way with QR codes, they can be a little bit of the emperor's new clothes. You know, everybody seems to think these are great and all that, and a lot of us that have been using them for a while going, oh, yeah, look, you know, this is kind of stupid, you know, if they're used wrong. And that's what I would say 90% of the people I see with using QR codes right now are using them wrong. And to the point, if you know the right way to use a QR code, it really is laughable. And they're really wasting their money, in my opinion. Okay, so now I'm not going to get really technical with this. Basically, how we got to where we are in the United States, it all started with QR1 technology, okay? The data elements in QR1 was 21 by 21. We're all the way up to QR4 now, which has 177 by 177 data bits, data elements in it, which means it can decipher web elements very easily and read a lot of information. And that's where we are in the United States, is about on QR4 technology. There is QR5 technology in Japan and Great Britain, but we are not there yet. And I don't know if we will be for a while. And a lot of it has to do with bandwidth on our smartphones, because in most other countries, they have satellites that downlink to our cell phones. So I don't know if we'll ever quite get the bandwidth to go for what's called QR5. The QR5 is something you want to avoid. If anybody ever says, hey, download this QR5 code, it's not going to work in the United States. So do not waste your time. It's a waste of time, and it will not work in the United States. Your phone, now a lot of newer ones you probably see, they already come with a QR scanner. Just download them for free. It's real simple.
How many of you have a QR scanner?
So,
how many of you use your QR scanner?
Yes, I can't trip too many. I've got to watch those things. So the phone, now if you don't have them, you can go to your phone and just, you know, download free QR scanners, Google it, and you'll see that there's tons of them. You can, you know, UPC, there's a few of them out there. Just be careful which ones you take, but, you know, Apple's got tons of the applications too. The phones that scan to the internet, you've got to be careful that if you download the wrong one, it can make your phone kind of cumbersome and not work right. So make sure you get the right one that's compatible to that phone. So you want to kind of, you know, if you're unsure, just look in the chat rooms, and the applications will have certain star ratings, like 5 stars, 3 stars, whatever, 4, whether it's Android or iPhone. So these here, the videos and B-cards, right from a QR code, take you right to a video. So we, a lot of times, will have to go right straight to YouTube videos, probably where we use them the most. The YouTube videos are really good. You can send your information, the card, the calendar, go right straight to any Google Docs you want, really anywhere, obviously the internet will take you. You can program to do. Maps are really good. I've had good luck with maps with QR codes.
So are you saying that, you're saying I've got this reader on my phone, and you've got a QR code on your whatever, and I scan it, it will automatically pop up whatever it is you told it to automatically pop up on my phone?
Yeah.
How do I know what it is that's going to pop up? Is it like a surprise? Or?
That's a great question. I'll get to that later.
Okay.
That's on my note list.
Okay.
Great question. Very good question. Yeah, that's the biggest violation of QR codes right now. Okay, so a perfect example, you could have just, if you mailed me a letter or a fax, you could have said, hey, Ron, scan the QR code, and you could have made a Google map for this location, and I could just print it. Okay, there it is. They weren't good. So maps, invites, tweets, you can, you know, give people tweets off that, PDF files, of course, phone, text, emails, etc. There's a little bit of an art to this, but you can make the QR code on your website go to a URL. So you can kind of make it be two purposes. where you have a QR code that you can use in print media, but that same QR code can be on your website where they press on it and they click on it and take you anywhere. There's a little bit of, it's not that big of a deal, I'm not going to get into that tonight, but you can Google, there's people out there doing it. So it's very, very easy to do. It's a few clicks if you know what you're doing. So that's kind of cool. And the reason you want that is, for example, if you had a restaurant or something, and you had a menu or website in the restaurant, you would go scan the QR code for our directions or our coupon or whatever, and then now it's in their phone. So it's something you, in sales, for example, there's a thing called hands-on. And in this case, it's phone. You want that information in the phone. The QR code was wonderful for getting stuff in their phone. So you can see how this would work for, you know, real estate, cars, things like that, because it's in the phone, and that's what you want. You want to capture them and then have them take their information with them. So people ask me all the time, what's the big deal with these QR codes? What's the big hype? Why would you even use them? Well, it all gets down to mobile. Mobile, mobile, mobile. How many people have smartphones in this room? Okay, I mean, pretty straightforward, you know. And so a year from now, everybody's going to raise their hand, and it's just growing, growing, growing. And, you know, a lot of times, obviously, smartphones, it's a matter of, you know, ease and money and convenience. You know, I don't like carrying a smartphone around with me all the time because they break, you know. It's my home a lot, but, you know, skin and stuff like that. Increased 27% in 2010 alone. Predicted increase by 40% this year, an additional 40%. The usage and the purchasing of smartphones will quadruple by 2014. So that's all we want to do, is we want to be mobile. Okay? And when you're... Did you focus on WordPress?
We just opened a WordPress.
Okay. Blog, yeah. So when you're downloading your WordPress templates, make sure you find one of the mobile WordPress templates. Or double check it, make sure it's mobile friendly. So that's key nowadays. Google says less than 9% of all sites now are mobile friendly. And Google is going to start weighing their algorithm on mobile friendly sites if you search on mobile device. Because remember, Google's got a user experience. And if you're searching on the internet from a mobile device, they're going to give the mobile sites preference. So from an SEO perspective, it works wonderful for it to have a mobile site. And I'd say right now, about, would you say, Jeremy, a quarter of the templates out there are mobile friendly with WordPress? 10%?
Yeah, it depends.
Okay, let's say 10-20% of the sites now on WordPress that you can download for free are mobile friendly. I kind of touched on this earlier. This is really the first time in the history of internet, since the internet started putting traditional media out of business, that now you've got a way to connect traditional media, newspapers, magazines, publications, things like that, brochures, print companies, with the internet. So the media companies, if they're smart, are jumping all over this. And it's like I told a lot of these media companies, just make the QR code for them for free. If you make it, they will come. It takes you 2 seconds. Of course, they're a little bit slower to adapt, especially in this town. But it does combine wonderfully traditional with new media. And that's really the first time since the internet this has happened. You know, besides putting www. On your page. You know. So what you're seeing now is really have companies, right? But you don't see them with the www. You see them generally with Facebook, Twitter, and maybe LinkedIn, and the QR barcode. You hardly, you know, it's almost a way to date your company anymore. It's almost like having your mailing address on your ad, right? To have the www address anymore. People just assume you're going to go to Google and find it. So it's a good way to date your company by not having some of this stuff. Cool thing is, kind of like how Facebook was a few years ago, is it's cool. You put a barcode on there, a QR code on your ad, kind of, there's a coolness factor to it. Or gee whiz, you know, download this. So for right now in the U.S., you'll get the people like, oh my God, I got to download it. So you'll get this kind of gee whiz moment with these people too. The sizes, U.S. sizes here, I'm not talking about centimeters, 0.85 inch, so almost an inch. You know, generally you want to make them, well, the Google default is 0.85 inch. So if you go to Google and you download their approved URL, which they generally tend to be the best, you will get a 0.85 inch, generally speaking. Okay, now, you can go all the way to unlimited size. Okay, so, a perfect example is, anybody know when the Bay Bridge in Oakland is supposed to be done next year? Anyhow, Google wants to drape a QR code all the way to the bay. And, you know, they're going to give millions of dollars to do it, so there is no limit to a QR code size.
So would you really scan that with your phone?
Yeah, you have to do that a certain way. Yeah, but the phone focuses on it automatically. You really got to worry about the smallness, if anything. It's the size. If it's too small, it makes it difficult to scan. But the big ones, your phone will tend to adjust. You know, you got to be back far enough, of course. You know, billboards, they adjust wonderfully. So you can really unlimited. So in Japan, Great Britain, they're everywhere. They're on billboards, they're on park benches, they're just everywhere. There was a classic one in Japan, because they're really into QR codes. And they have been for a long time. They were invented there. But they actually turned the lights off in a building in a certain way, and made a building a QR code. So that was kind of interesting. So the patterns in the building made the QR code. And you just simply emulate. You can do it with checkers and stuff like that. It's all already YouTube creative ways to do that. Pretty cool. You can change the QR code. So let's say, for example, you spent a lot of money on print. But a restaurant would be a perfect example. So let's say you've already got your menus made, and you're running ads and stuff, but you change the prices. And, you know, your new web page reflects the new prices. We just go in and reprogram that QR code. The QR code stays the same, but the URL changes. So you can actually, even though the QR code never changes, you can make its destination change. So that's pretty cool.
But if the QR code is linked to a URL, you can update the content at that URL.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's what you're doing. So it's changeable, so that's pretty cool. But there's also people that will let you, or probably do that for you, but it's so easy just to redirect. It's pathetic. You know, really, you shouldn't have to pay. When I first started messing around with QR codes, I was looking all over for free ones. To just give you an idea, a year and a half, I was paying $99 a month to make unlimited QR codes. And 6 months ago, it was $49 a month. Now, as the internet goes, it's free. That's typically with the internet. You wait long enough, it's free, which is great. I'm waiting for that to happen with gasoline. If we keep waiting, won't gas be free? It goes the opposite. The reader, the QR code reader, will adjust for inverted. So if you have a QR code wrapped around a telephone pole, it will adjust. The reader in your phone will adjust for something that's inverted. So a lot of times, if you've got a band or something like that, and you put things around town, it will adjust for an inverted QR code. It'll also, if it's upside down, actually, I meant curved. Inverted, if it's upside down, of course, it will still read it. So they're pretty good about reading it. You got to watch the light there. My next slide says that. So if you are reading in the dark, I would say probably minimum, you know, almost like a candlelight type of light. And it can be pitch black. But, you know, they're pretty good nowadays at reading these things. Who's using them? Only 9.5% of small to medium-sized businesses right now are using them. So it's still a pretty small percent in the U.S. In Japan, it's closer to about 90 to 95% typically. Europe, about 80, 90% right in there. So we're late adapters, and part of it is because obviously the whole smartphone thing, and we're just now getting up to, you know, 3G and 4G technology on the phone, so that enabled us to do it. So that works out pretty good. Industry, you can use them for inventory tracking. That's how they're originally developed. They're invented to track parts for codes. So it's really simple. They just went in and that's how they inventory their parts. They've been on our power bill forever. You probably just didn't notice it. So there's ways, you don't need a phone to do them. A lot of times they'll use them just in processing and scanning devices. A lot of times they're built in scanning devices for billing companies. So they have been in the U.S. on a smaller level. So, perfect example on tags for retail. Quicksilver, for example, you can scan it and it takes you to the Huntington Beach live. So you can scan it and you'll see people surfing down Huntington Beach. So there's unique ways to do it. So you can put them right on the tags. You can put them on your ads, on your windows. After they purchase it, they can get their coupon later on from downloading additional information. So a lot of times after you open the box, there's a QR code in there. So there's really crafty ways to do these. Coupons are probably one of the best ways, in my opinion. I haven't seen this yet, but this is something I always imagined, that it's great for a trailer. You know, I imagine you're going to start seeing these on the
poster for the movie, and then you can see the QR code and download the trailer here. Has anybody seen that? But I mean, you will start seeing them. So anytime, with a lot of this stuff on the internet, you kind of think in your mind, okay, they'll probably start doing it. And a couple months later, they will. It just goes without saying. Documents, you know, instead of, perfect example is an attorney can just, you know, scan a bunch of QR codes and have it right there in the smartphone instead of turning the whole briefcase in for documents. So there's ways you can do that with documents. Libraries, you can download books from libraries. Now, this is what's going on in Europe right now as we speak. So in Europe, you just go to a library and you can download the whole book right in your phone and your panel. Museums, the QR codes are in most of the museums. Not most. I'd say, from what I saw, they were in about a third of the museums when I was there a couple of years ago. In Japan, they're pretty much in all the museums. They're just, the Japanese, are, they just can't give enough of these reasons. Any technology, I don't care if it's that or the internet in general. The museums are good because, of course, they scan it, and then they're able to get the history of the artist, the history of the picture, whatever. So you get all that with the scanning devices. Authors, these are great for authors. What I imagine, in fact, I'm doing a presentation at the Writers of Purple Cities on Saturday. It's going to be mostly about Facebook, but we are going to touch on QR codes. I'm telling these authors, like, hey, put a QR code on all your printed material and all your blogs and everything so you can download part of their book. So I think authors have a lot of stuff, features, and all of that. Who else is using them? The uninformed. So we'll talk about some mistakes later. And again, most of the people are uninformed about QR codes. And they're basically using them now. The uninformed, the Me Too's, the also-rans, the people that are just trying to be cool, they think they need to be having QR codes, they think they need to be on Facebook, they think they need to be on Twitter, and all this stuff, LinkedIn, whatever, but they're doing it all wrong. And we all see the mistakes. So you do get the also-rans. You know, a lot of these people are, you know, guilty just in our own marketing departments right here in town. You know, these casinos, they pay big bucks for these marketing events. It doesn't mean they know how to generate a QR code, or it doesn't know they need no social media. A lot of you guys in this room, I guarantee you, the president of Wikipedia, know more than most of these marketing. I gotta watch what I say. So anyhow, you guys probably both know more than most marketing people around the United States. How's that sound? And the know-it-alls, of course. The know-it-alls. You know, everybody's using a QR code because they think they know it all. Just like they know it all because they're on Facebook. And you know, I can stop it right here. Anybody just, while we're on the subject, anybody else think just off the top of their head of what some usage would be? Anything? Any use at all? You know, might not have touched on it.
Well, we have them at my store on, like, HP does them on printers, and you can scan it, and I'll give you just a little bit more information about the printer.
Yeah. So. And that works out good, too. See, now that's a perfect example where after you buy the product, there's a QR code for the information. Look how much paper that saved us.
Well, no, it's on, like, our printed stuff, and the customer has to take out their phone.
Okay.
And then they can get more information.
Yeah.
When we're packaging for product information, dimension size.
Yeah.
I'm surprised you're not seeing them in your textbook. I mean, that would be, there'd be perfect, you know, when you get to certain places in the textbook, you can scan a QR code and there'd be a video or some extra text, like you want to read extra text, or a brief audio, you know, but it seems like it would be perfect for that. You won't have textbooks 5 years from now. Yeah, you'll go to the bookstore and scan the QR code.
Well, you know what amazes me is, I don't have an e-reader, but I don't think there's a scanning device or a picture device on the e-reader, right? You'd think they'd have an e-reader so you could scan it right in the e-reader. I don't know why that don't happen. Unless I have a QR code scanning device, it'd be wonderful for me. That's kind of surprising. I imagine in the future there. Any other suggestions while we're just kind of brainstorming?
So you could make a, so let's say that you have a, you're doing this personal branding and you have a profile page, like an About Me where everything lands, links to all of your social sites, they're all there. So you can go create yourself a QR code, go to that URL, a business card.
Yeah, a business card one.
Yeah.
I've got some samples.
Now could you put a URL, let's say you did it, let's say you got that QR code linked to your website, you could put it on a business card, could you also put it in an email? Yeah. Like, could you have it in your email signature? Absolutely. Line? Yeah. Copy it in there?
Yeah. In fact, I run the, you know, real estate investment, and I do put a QR code in the invite all the time. And part of the reason, I give directions in the email, and I also give a Google Maps link. But I also, in that Google Map, that same Google Map, I also put the QR code. And the reason is, a lot of times people like to print directions, or they like to print who the speaker's going to be. And I know I have a lot of older people in that group, and it's kind of a pet peeve of me, and you guys probably know that people just print everything. It's like, do you really need to print the email? But they do. So a lot of times, knowing they print it, I'll put a QR code in the body of the email. And then a lot of times, not in this particular case, a lot of times you can make that QR code a link on the internet. So that's pretty cool. And by the way, you can also make a YouTube, a hot link on the internet too, like pressing on the YouTube video. So that's really fun to do too. That's a different subject. Okay, so common mistakes is, we kind of mentioned that earlier, and this is the one of the biggest mistakes, is not telling them where it goes. Okay? Why, if somebody emailed you, if I clicked on this link, check it out, and it's a big question mark, you're going to click on it, you're going to know. You know, I mean, what is it going to be, spam? Is it somebody hijacked his email? So why would you scan a code and risk ruining your phone, risk a virus going into all your contacts, frying your phone, and it doesn't tell you where it's taken. So tell them where the destination takes it. No different, I was the same one of you guys a link, I would tell you where that link's going to take it. It's in a question mark. So that's one of the biggest violators right now. Kind of like the forest box of chocolates, and you never know what you're going to get. You know, again, scanning one and getting a virus or spam. The spammers are now starting to figure these out quite a bit. So you're starting to see them on street corners now, or, you know, scan here for a free ticket, and of course it goes to a bad site or some diet pills or something, or Viagra or whatever. Here's an interesting statistic. And this is, I want to say Google came out with the statistics, but something big. Is not informing the basic usage. So again, if we just put a QR code out there without the destination, you're going to get a 0.5%, less than 1%, and half 1% are going to actually scan that thing. The minute we put the destination up there, you get a 15% scan rate. So that says that 15% of the people that look at your ad are going to scan that thing if you tell them where to go. So that's pretty good statistics there. So that's really good. Now, over-informing basic usage. Obviously, if I'm in a high-tech group, a perfect example is I volunteer group with the Silicon Mountain Group. Well, they sent out a flyer the other day, I noticed. And there was a speaker there, and they just put a QR code there, but I know that I'm going to scan it and get information about the speaker, information about the group, because that's a tech-savvy group. But generally speaking, you want to instruct relative to your audience. So in America, and I would say in Reno, for example, you want to keep it pretty simple. We got it down to use smartphone, scan, life. Four words. And other people, they overanalyze of what they put. So you can put too much, you can put too little, or you can not put anything at all. So you have to watch that. On one hand, you want to inform, but you don't want to inform too much. Like, oh, download the reader here, go to this site, go to that site, do this, do that, and they'll never do it. So it's kind of in the world of Twitter. Think Twitter when you're telling them how to download these things. Too long of a URL. Okay, the reason you need to shorten the URL. You know, a lot of times Facebook has a really long URL. So you get, what is it, 25 friends or something, you get these really long URLs. So if you try to make a QR code, all that information has to go into the code. Or, you know, if it's something where there's 100 characters on the website. So you want to go in and shorten it so that the code doesn't have as much bits of information. Okay, and that's why you don't want too long of a URL. Now, I would say, for example, I've got one site, you know, www.rondellrealtor.com, that's fine. But if it was really long, I would go into Google and shorten it. So because the code, it has to go into the QR code, so it's too long of a URL. That's why Google's a big fan of shortening the URL. All right.
Being trendy, this is the social media 101 here. A big mistake is being trendy and not understanding what you're doing and not having a game plan on these things. So if you don't just start using them, throwing spaghetti at the wall. Come up with a game plan. Where's it going to take me? Where it takes me is that relative to the ad I'm running, the demographics I'm trying to get, and the call to action I'm trying to get. So you really want to have a plan. What's the end game? And then when they get there, if you're in sales, what's my capture? What's my call to action? Things like that. Don't just have some just crazy site or some stupid place to go. Being trendy, no understanding your plan. Not testing, tracking your analytics. Okay, so not testing. Test the thing out on your own smartphone before you release it to print. There's a statistic out there right now that something like 40% of them don't work. Because they're making them and they're not testing them. And they're also putting in print, and after it's printed with the printer, the printer's not testing them. So I would say if any of you guys are going to run a big, huge run on some printed stuff, either make sure that printer's got a smartphone, or when you send you the proof, scan it and make sure it works. You don't want to spend $5,000 on some big run of some nice glossy catalog or something and all of a sudden have the dark look not working. So make sure you test them. That's the biggie. That's the basic. Tracking analytics. Google Now, and he mentioned that it, you know, Brett and I are both big fans of, if you get into social media and even QR codes now, it's get the Gmail accounts. It's the basic because everything flows so much easier. Just everything works well with the Gmail and stuff. So once you're signed into your Google account, whether it's Gmail or anywhere else, you can then go in, I'll give the site in a second, you can go in and make these QR codes free of course. Now, there's a little area down there where you get more, and then that'll get you into the analytics. And then, so what you want to do is, if you have a bunch of these out there, you can actually tell how many people download it. So Google allows you to track the analytics now, again, for free. A year ago, you would have been paying hundreds of a year to be able to find the company.
So you're saying you could make those in Google?
Yeah. I know you've got sites right here for everybody. I'm going to pass them out a bit.
Whether or not they were directed to that site via internet traffic or via.
Right. Okay. So, a perfect example would be as a realtor, for example. I could have ran an ad for 20 homes. Now, I can go back in, each home has a different one, and maybe I can see how many of the homes have been downloaded. So, or ads, coupons, specials, you can see how many of them. So, that's really cool.
Is there a like for that QR code that you make?
That's a great question. That was one of the things that I asked. And you always wonder, kind of like when I was a kid, was are they ever going to run out of barcodes? Yeah. It's impossible, apparently. Because they're just changing. You would think, especially with a barcode, they would run out on the way down. So it's kind of the same thing that I wondered when I was a little kid, were they going to run out of barcodes? And the answer is no. That's a great question. All right. The analytics. Return on investment. Sure, he's hammered that into you guys. Is it worth your time? Is it worth the investment of doing this? Because it's going to take up space. Ads are expensive. You know, if you're a realtor, for example, or any other business, and you're running these full-color ads, well, that's a chunk of space there. It really is. So you've got to make sure that it's going to be worth putting that on it. Or even your business card. And I'm going to show you some mistakes made on business cards. So is it really worth putting it on your business card? I think it's better off in the back in most applications, but is it going to be worth it? Let's go through some common questions. You know what I'm going to do is let's get to, so I'm going to pass these out while we're doing this, and I want to go to some just do's and don'ts first. Let's just do the don'ts. What do you guys want to hear first? Don'ts or do's? I was just trying to, don'ts, do's, what do you guys want to hear first?
Don'ts,
yeah, that way we can show the correct way. Okay, good. All right, now, this is textbook. Again, these people make a lot of money. I'm sure they're nice people. We've probably all seen this ad. This is right out of, I think, Battery Escape or something. We know the deck now. Okay. That's how it goes. Okay, now, there's Sammy on there, okay? And it's a Sammy. Celebrate the legacy, da da da, right? Okay, it looks like there's a. It must be somebody. Sammy is dead, right? So it must be somebody that's dead. But anyhow, they got some kind of thing that would show us what Sammy did. Okay, so is the QR code, does it take me this information about Sam? I don't know. No, wait, here's the thing where it goes, now there's a Sammy showroom. Okay, so is this about the Sammy showroom? Now here it's talking about the reservations, okay?
Does the QR code take me to the reservation? Am I supposed to scan that to get a reservation?
Well, here's Harris Reno. The QR code takes me to the Harris site? Where does it take me?
Okay. Well, it's just sitting down there with that. It doesn't say where it goes.
Okay. So these guys drank the Kool-Aid, found out that they want to be cool and hip. I'm surprised the Facebook and Twitter logos. Where's the Facebook and Twitter logo? It takes you to that sucky Facebook page. It's not even on there. Okay. So there you go. This is about the worst violation, in my opinion, of the QR code.
But see, that would have, is that a Harris ad?
Yeah.
If that's a Harris ad, there is a big money agency behind it.
And they don't know what
they're doing. It's not a mom and pop agency. Yeah. Yeah. That is a major agency behind it that generated and was able to tell Harris you need to pull out a full page ad. Yeah. So, I mean, that is. Yeah, that's a major business.
And when I leave here today, everybody in this room is going to know 10 times as much as QR code than that major agency put. And you guys, I can guarantee you know more about Facebook and Twitter and LinkedIn than any of this bullshit. Okay. So, and that's one of the biggest mistakes, frankly, of both QR code and social media within the marketing department in charge of this stuff. You know, because it's such a specialized field now with social media. But here's an interesting one. And this is actually done by Stacy over there now. She's a member of the social media group. And, you know, bless her heart. But it's a little bit of a mouthful. So this QR code here, to me, our cancer nurse navigator, so good. She tells me what she's going to do, scan this QR code. Now, that would have been good enough, scan this QR code. To download a QR code reader, go to your preferred app store, an Apple or an Android store, da-da-da-da-da-da. Right? So she goes on to this big spiel about. So it sounds a little technical, right? So, you know, be careful, not too much information. So you want to just enough information there. Now this is interesting. In typical Microsoft fashion, Microsoft has to charge the QR code. We can actually put that up there. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to pass them around here in a second right now. So, that's fine. Actually, this one would be a really good. Get that one, and I want to show them this one. This one got really important. I'll just kind of keep these going. Okay, so same deal here, same thing. This is off of like Rob Reporter, one of the very expensive magazines. Where's it taken? Again, the number one violator. Where's it taken? Okay, the number two biggest violator, by the way, is when it goes there. This is probably in my mistakes. Make sure it's a mobile-friendly site. If you're reading on a mobile device, make sure it's a mobile-friendly site. Again, it's less than 9%. Okay, so this is the Microsoft free mobile app for your phone, okay? Which is okay, but couldn't you have just left it alone? Now, if you go there, it's going to be hard to download, and, you know, they want to do it in color, they want to do all this stuff, and guess what? Apple and Google hate Microsoft. So you're going to have a harder time with an iPhone and Android downloading Microsoft products.
So when they say snap this tag, what is snap this tag?
That means scan. Exactly. It's Microsoft. They've got to do it different. That's scan.
Okay.
Yeah.
That means scan.
Yeah, it means scan. Of course they have to, you know, they can't just like, okay, it's cool, you know.
Snap this tag.
Yeah. And you know what? They're beautiful with that said. They do a good job. But that's effectively doing the same thing. That is a barcode reader. Put this guy over. This is really a biggie here. There's some blatant violations here. This one, yeah. This one, by the way, here is, there's no instruction on this one. But I don't like this one. And you can kind of see this from a distance. You see how it's too light? You got to watch the lightness. You know, black and white, frankly, is the best. But you can play with color, but this, the text is going to mess around with it. The text is too close to it.
So this guy's got that on his business card, but it doesn't tell you what you're going to get when you
scan. Absolutely, yeah. And who the heck wants it? You know, nice little suit. He's got the kind of, you know, nowadays the collar thing and the knot ties in, you know. But he's got that there. And just like you said, there's that. Again, probably takes you to the sucky Facebook page. Probably Twitter is not doing a damn thing. It's probably LinkedIn that hasn't been updated ever, right? So, and this is typical not just with realtors, everybody. I mean, if you're going to do this stuff, do it. Otherwise, don't mess around with it. It just cheapens you. So here they went so far as to put on his clothes. Again, is there really a return on investment to have that thing right there on your body? You know?
And you don't know what you get when you... You don't even know what you get when you scan it there.
Okay, exactly.
Is that necessarily... That's not necessarily the same QR code. You would assume that it is, but you don't know that it's the same code.
These are supposed to be, from what I would gather, the QR code for this house, right? Okay, so he doesn't tell you that that goes... Oh, by the way, a very simple way is put your domain underneath the QR code, okay? So if that was... You just go www.123mainstreet.com. It'd be real simple. So real simple way is just put your domain underneath the QR code. You're good. So you put it at the top, scan code QR code, split the smartphone, and right below that for your www address. So you'd be good there. So there's pretty violation here again. This would, I would assume, take you to this. Now I blackened this out. This is cool. This is Mark. He works in the office. I told him I was going to show him up there because I gave everybody a heck about these. By the way, they paid big money to have this. This is the new look that's going to be called Furnished. You know, so whatever. This, I assume, takes you to a different realtor to his website, but again, he doesn't tell you, like Brett mentioned. Is there any other ones? Can you scoot that up or down? Or, this is pretty bad. So, now, these guys pay $800 a month for these ads. These are very expensive ads. If you were the homeowner, would you be happier? Okay, this is in this month's Homes and Land magazine. Okay? If you were the Truckee River, but I mean, beautiful Truckee River, beautiful photo, and one quarter of the photo is wasted on a barcode. These are not this cool. These are not this unique to waste these beautiful photos. Okay, so it's kind of crazy. So I mean, you can see I blacked out his name.
So can you embed, I guess that you wouldn't be able to do that, embed a code within a code so that you would click on a QR code. Like, he's got several properties listed here.
Yeah.
There's no way to have this one code that would take you to some type of thing where you could get more information on...
Yeah, that would just be a standard website.
If you have your website, do that.
You go click here for this, click here for that, yeah. And you could put codes, different codes at that point.
QR code just for this one right.
He really doesn't need them for every individual property. He's just trying to be trendy and cool and tell his sellers that he's the latest guy, right? And he knows all this stuff. People, I've been using these things for a year and a half. There's nothing that special about them, you know? I mean, it was cool a year and a half sitting down at people's tables, but no more. Why don't you put a list full up here?
You're on the safe side.
That's all right.
Oh, that's you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know if it's a do or a don't, okay? But this is on my Facebook page. People give me heck about it because now everybody knows it's a QR code. For a while, it was kind of unique. They're like, what is this? So this has been on my Facebook page for about a year. Okay? Now this, and I'm going to give you a site, this is a custom QR code. Okay? So without getting too technical, this lines up your scanning device, these 3 points here. So I'm going to make sure these 3 points are here.
Can you put your picture in a QR code?
Absolutely. I'm going to give you guys a free site to do it. We used to have to do this in Photoshop. It used to take me all day to go in. The first logo I dropped in there for Coble Banker Corporate took me about 14 hours in Photoshop to do because I had to go in and extrapolate items into what they call the white space. You can do whatever you want in this white space. Okay. And there's a certain amount of white space out here on the sides if you know what you're doing that you can do. But yeah, you can make them custom in there with logos and stuff. So I don't know, I'm borderline, it's a do or don't, but anyhow, it's on my Facebook page, it's the silliest thing ever. And give me that thing back, so these guys don't crack me.
We'll go back to there.
So I'm going to pass the don'ts around if you guys want. And let me see if these do's are even worthy of putting on the screen. In fact, yeah, let's do this, okay? Let's put this guy on the screen right here. Those of you guys, I had a surprise for you.
You know, I'm going to turn this over to him.
Okay, so, this is actually a page that Jeremy just finished the other day. Jeremy does what they call custom Facebook websites, and so he finished this for Chewy down here at the Fresh Next. Okay, so all you have to do, and I'll pass this around if anybody wants to scan it from their phone, can you scan this? Okay, so like us on Facebook for a complimentary taco. Okay, quiz here. Where's this going to take you? Who's Facebook? Okay, what do we tell them to do? Use smartphone, scan, like. So we got that down to one line. All right, so we didn't have a bunch of verbiage there. Is it too short? I don't know, but boy, that sure is sexy, in my opinion. So like us on Facebook for Account for Mary Taco, so they know they're going to scan that right there. That doesn't take you to his website, in this case his Facebook site. It takes you to a page, a tab on his Facebook for the taco. Okay, so it takes you right to that page.
A taco tab.
Yeah. And so I'm going to actually pass that around. Any of you guys can do that. If you don't have smartphones, the code is FB Taco, right? Okay, so write that down. You go into Chewy's and tell them FB Taco. So it's got to like its page. FB Taco. It's fresh and extra, you know. FB Taco, and you get a free taco. So it's pretty cool. And if you all say that, you all get a free taco. Okay?
Drop this in.
Now, this is a missed opportunity here, of course. Okay, now this, I wrote that in there. What a missed opportunity. These things are at all the Baskin Robbins. Like us on Facebook. And of course, you get to the Facebook page, it's just a wall. It's not a custom page or anything, it's just a wall. And so nowadays, the thing is with businesses, you want a custom Facebook page. As of March 1st, you can make Facebook page that site if your business goes up. So it would have been a wonderful opportunity to put a QR code there. Scan here to like us on Facebook. Real simple. And so from liking it, now here's the thing with Facebook and business. When you want to get somebody to like your page, give them an incentive. You see how Chewy was giving them a taco? They could go scan here for free kids' ice cream cone. And what do? They walk in their store, they're going to scan right there, of course. And they're going to get their kid a free ice cream cone. Now you've got another like on your page. That's how you build up likes. So the QR code works wonderful for cross-marketing Facebook, Twitter, anything like that. So that's pretty cool. I'm just going to pass these around. Well, here's a couple. This custom one's pretty cool. Here's a few more custom ones. Just throw these up there since we're getting fancy. I'm going to pass the dumps around. I don't think I'm going to need to do it. You got a song. Okay, so this is something we did with our logo for our custom. You know, with Jeremy and I, we designed custom Facebook pages for companies. So we dropped this into there. This is pushing it right there. This is about, when you get into custom, that's about how much you want to push it. We pushed that one all the way to the edge, but it worked out pretty good. And obviously, you blow these up to get blurry.
Could you even, so there's a logo in the middle of there. Could you, like for the Chewy one, could you have put the instructions right in this in there? Could you have said, scan?
No, because you could if you created a white background, yeah. But yeah, because what happens is if you have a transparent back logo, for example, you have a logo that, let's say, just had, you know, white space or clear space behind it, you have to have something solid there in order to block out the black. So yeah, you could if you made something white behind it, definitely. So there's that. So there's plenty of other examples.
But you could, I mean, your QR code in the middle, it could have just said free taco, right?
Yeah. Exactly, but you would just have to put some white space behind it. So the big joke with this is just kind of a joke here is, you know, why are realtors in the QR code so much? It's just a distraction from your photo that's 20 years old, high school photo. Okay, so you can see this is, I don't know if this is Europe or where, oh, Kanye West. Okay. Now here they put a heart in there. So they took out the white space, and they put a heart in there. So that is a custom code, so Kanye West, or whatever that does. So snap and send to get updates, ringtones, and other free stuff. So you can see here, this is kind of Kanye West ringtone. They're probably going to charge you for that. So you can see these on billboards. This particular magazine, we don't need to scan it, but this was out of the Bay Area. This was Kirk Bailey. He talked briefly, and I'd like to see him put a QR code here. He talked briefly on how to do it. Every single one of his properties, whether they like it or not, he gives them a QR code. Okay? That way he's got consistency in his magazine. Doesn't have one and then the other. Now, he doesn't tell in the ads to do that, but he does tell them in the front, so I would give him a do. Anyhow, this is the Google. This is the graph, and I just drew that in there. If you go to Google, and you go in, this is where you'll track your analytics. The Google URL shortening is how you can actually just Google it to find it. Cool.
I didn't even know Google had a URL shortening.
Yeah, they got that, and it goes right to the...
It makes sense.
Yeah. Now, when you go to Google, when you make that shortened URL, it's kind of tricky to find the QR code. You have to hit after you make your QR code, you're going to see just in typical Google fashion, you're just going to see one little thing that says more.
And you got to click on more, and that'll get you to your tracking.
But they're not real obvious about the tracking. You really have to watch for that thing. And not enough tracking even matters. So you get the apps at App Directory, UPC, types of files, JPEG, PDF, TIFF, Publisher, pretty much all kinds of files that go in there. Is it print ready? Yes, it's pretty straightforward. Although I would caution you to, you know, have a good... I would directly email it to them. I wouldn't fax it to them, of course. Can it be reused? Yes. Can I copy and paste? Yes. But you generally need to save it as an image first. Because, of course, I mean, unless you've got the updated Adobe products, you know, Adobe's not a big fan of the PDF. You like to copy and paste. Track, yes. Google URL shortener. Distance, you typically want to be a foot or more from a QR code. So if you're too close, it's not going to zero in on the aligner. Further away, obviously size matters. So if people are driving by in a car, you need something that can go both sides. So the classic mistake that realtors are making right now is that they're putting QR codes. Let's say that their QR code is just maybe 4x6. Well, people in a car, one of them want to get out of their car to read that. It's not going to read it. You need a sign, in that case, about 12 inches by 12 inches. So, that's kind of a mistake I'm also seeing is if you expect somebody to scan that thing from their phone, that'd be a pretty big QR code. And then again, test. Go back to your car and go, okay, I want them to test this from their, or scan it from their car. Go back and test it. Go scan that. Always test where you're going to be doing it, test your audience and all that. So make sure that all that. Night, we talked about that. Size 0.85. Okay. So it's 0.85 minimum in the U.S. Japan's got theirs down to very small. They're very, very small in Japan. But it's just they have a different technology there. They're into the QR5. In Japan, they're very small. And a lot of the media set down to the satellite thing. Now, in Japan, for example, it's a very small country. And they're very limited in size. So if you go into a supermarket in Japan, it's actually a virtual. More or less a virtual supermarket. So there's just a picture of milk and you scan it. And then there's a picture of cereal, picture of bread. And then when you go out to your car, there's a guy sitting there and everything's all boxed out. You check out what they loaded in your car. Okay, because it comes out of, it's almost like just-in-time manufacturing, if you guys know what that is. It's almost like just-in-time shopping where by the time you walk out of the store, they've got all boxed ready to go. And that's because in Japan, real estate is very valuable and things are tight. Now, Google right now has a complete virtual supermarket mock-up in their campus, on their campus, and where you just go through and you scan everything, and as you walk out, the smartphone checks you right out, and they'll at that point either deliver the food to your house or load it like they did in Japan. So Google actually has somewhat done that here in the United States. Here's the QR links that you guys just got. This is the Google URL shortener. Pretty sure I got that right. Otherwise, just Google the actual Google your shortener. It's best to go in there from the either Gmail or one of your Google accounts. Otherwise, you won't be able to track your analytics, guaranteed. This is one of the earlier ones right here, 2dcode.company.uk. Be curious. It's pretty good. That's the one, by the way, that I made those custom ones on. Okay. This is my favorite. Be QRES. Be curious. So when you're on Be Curious, you hit graphics. And then you upload, it's a real simple browse, upload your file, boom, done. So, looking pretty good there. And if we got time, I can make one for you. Keiwa Densa Wave, that's actually invented it for Toyota. So they're the ones that invented it to our stuff. So these are all sites you can go make these. I pretty much hang out at Be Curious and go and Google. Those are my two babies. But any of these will work. Stronghold Marketing, that's if you really, really wanted to custom QR code, and a perfect example. I haven't seen anybody use this, but I was thinking about the other day, is you could have a stack of poker chips, for example, and hide a QR code in there, and tell somebody to scan it, and little things like that. So if you really wanted a custom QR code with some graphics, or something hid in the forest or something, Stronghold Marketing is a pay site.
and they'll basically do anything you want with the QR code. But you can do a lot of yourself. And then on my YouTube channel, just Ron Dell Realtor, I've got videos on QR code that I've done myself, and I've also poached off of YouTube and things like that. So, and added, you know, a lot of them are in Japanese, so I just added some. And there's one really cool one on my YouTube channel. It's a guy with just checkers and making QR code and his art fly out of it. So that's pretty cool. And then there's my information there. And what else do we have? That is it. Anybody got any questions?
Question. How do you put on a business card? How do you do that?
Oh, it's easy. If you're doing it your own, you just, you know, just drop it into the publisher or anything like that. It's pretty simple. Just browse, drop in, no different than you do a picture. It's just sitting in a file. Mm-hmm. Or you email it to your printer. Yeah. So it's just a file, you know. But the file can be, you know, numerous ways. But, and you can convert it, obviously you can change the file in your computer too.
My question is, do you think that QR and RFID technologies like NFC are complementary or more competitive?
Probably complementary. The other ones are used more in manufacturing and things, from what I've seen, in more radio wave type of stuff, right?
Yeah. It's non-line of sight, don't have to take a picture.
Yeah, exactly. I'd say they're probably complementary, and there's no reason you can't, there's different applications for all of those.
Many RFID tags have the QR code right on top of them.
Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah, so they're probably just accenting each other. Yeah. And by the way, if you go to Best Buy, you'll see them pretty much on all theirs. So if you're in front of a Sony television, just download it, and you've got all the specs, you've got the prices and everything. So Best Buy is probably one of the early adapters of retail. And who knows? You don't know if any of this stuff's a passing fad or not. You look at MySpace, you look at Google Base. You never know when you start to do this how much of a passing fad it is. I think it's trendy and it's being misused now, but the people that use it right and the right companies and the right applications, it'll always be around. No different than a scanner. And these things could go crazy, and they probably will. My thoughts are that you'll probably see them more often than not.
You mentioned the viruses and scam as kind of an upcoming problem or whatnot. What is there to prevent? Like, I don't see what security there is for a phone or a smartphone or whatnot from a hacker, say, if I scan one of those codes and send me to a site that, gives them all my information or whatever. I mean, what protection is there for people to want to do that?
Well, there's not. That's why I would caution you. I mean, obviously, like that one I showed you, hair is more than likely to not some virus, but if you go, something's there on a telephone pole and stuff like that, I kind of caution you to be careful because, they could go in and just fry your phone. It could take over your address book. There ain't no different than a virus anywhere else. And they're starting. In Europe, the viruses are here. They haven't hit the U.S. because we haven't had QRs that long. It's just a matter of time. Yeah, you'll start hearing all the time people get viruses. Because this isn't the internet. Now, with that said, it depends if there's an ongoing link after that and if you can get your phone off in time, too. There's a fine line there. If you're sitting there watching it, you might be able to get off that site in time, but who knows? Some of those you cannot get rid of. We all remember some of those ones where you hit X and you couldn't get rid of it. There's some viruses out there. Once you got it, you can't get rid of it.
Yeah, because you're not signing off. The thing that scares me about the QR codes is just the vagueness of them. It's like you said, you can say where it's going or whatever, but how do you know?
Again, it gets down to who's sending it out.
Well, when you go to www.americanexpress, you don't necessarily know it's going to American Express. You have to, caveat emptor, right?
Yeah, it's caveat emptor, and a lot of that is just simply trusting the source. It's just, I'd be careful. In the Bay Area, in Silicon Valley, for example, they're pretty much in most of the restaurants, not the restaurants, but the bars and all the trendy places, so it's actually quite a sight watching the guys scan them. So you're starting to see them in the restrooms, in the men's restrooms quite a bit.
Yeah, people sticker. mine and stick it over there.
Yeah, that's a really good point.
Yeah. And I could print that off tonight and put it on a sticker and go put that over whatever I want. And every time they try to look at the menu, it'll redirect them to my site or wherever I am.
Yeah, and you know, a lot of these spammers, you know, they get paid by how many people go to the site. It might not necessarily be a virus, but that housewife that made that code just made 10 cents by you scanning that, you know. So, yeah.
You could post it over other posts, but instead of that, I just have to worry about when we're talking about.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, you could easily go over that and all that stuff. And it's just, you know, so that's why you gotta be careful. Did I pass around the free taco one?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, pass that around. So anybody with smartphones, scan that. You guys put that free taco in your site. Who's got smartphones? Anybody want to scan it? You don't have to if you don't want to. See, now I got you all. See, I should have passed this around before we had the viruses. I wouldn't worry too much of viruses about at this point. I would kind of keep an eye on it. You know, read the papers and see if you hear. I actually haven't heard of any. I mean, it's possible, but I haven't heard of any. That's for sure.
Ron, thank you very much.
Sure.
There you go. I didn't know any of that, so.
Yeah, I know. I was telling him about it. I was just like, I don't know about QR codes, so.